headed to Eastern Flockfield to look for a female leopard that was last seen heading from the Cheetah Pan towards the windmill.
Here we have a very young giraffe, probably only a couple of months old.
I saw this leopard just in this large open area, behaving very much like a cheetah. See how well that tactic works for her. Well, it looks as if she might have seen something. Can't see what exactly, but she's very alert. I'll stick with her. Liam, she's just stalking something where those little knobthorn thickets are. That's the nyala of a young kudu. Liam, she's quite close now, 10 meters. Stalking a young kudu, and it's run off now. There might be more in the area.
Here we can see the young female kudu that the Kapen female was stalking and looking for.
Just crossed over an open area into a thicket. three Kapen females busy stalking three, could be an adult and two younger ones. Just busily circling round towards the kudus.
Nick and I have come across a honey badger that's quite high up under the trees on the riverbank here. It's full of all sorts of debris and that from previous floods. I can only imagine he's looking for bird nests inside here. Actually also waiting for him to potentially fall out of this tree. So most rangers will tell you that buffalo is one of the most dangerous things you can walk into the reed beds along the river. I've since changed my answer to tree climbing honey badger. They terrify me. seconds, the lions have started to finally get moving. And just moving slowly, listening for what's going on up ahead of them. And just moving through their territory now. See, the lions are up and moving now. There's still a bit of light left for us. And hopefully we see them do something exciting. You can see how they just stop, start, listen out, figure out what's up ahead of them.
We managed to relocate this female leopard. After the kudus had seen her and started alarm calling, she had wandered off into a thicker area. About half an hour later, we ended up coming across her. Looks like she was stalking another herd of kudus who also ended up seeing her. So it's been a tough day for this female leopard. She's been seen twice now by two different herds of kudu, causing for her to now relax and rest. Maybe under the cover of darkness, she'll have a much better opportunity to hunt.